Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 20. 2 years ago, I attended the annual White House Garden Tour in Washington, D.C., and this was a photo that I took prior to entering the grounds. Yes, I did get inside the gate, and I do have pictures from inside the gate, which I hope to post at some point in the future. But today I thought I would work on this one, iconic symbol of Washington, D.C. and the United States. So let me begin. The first thing I'm going to do, and it was a gorgeous day, and the lawn was in fact that wonderful emerald color. Again, it was Garden Week, the White House Garden Tour, but it is a little bit on the blue side. I'm going to just warm it up a bit by coming into my white balance and sliding the slider just a little bit. And it picks up the tone of the sun and gives a little bit more depth to those to the sunlight in the picture. So from there, I'm not going to, the exposure is fine, and I'm not going to touch the contrast at this point. But I am going to come down and I'm going to open up the shadows because the trees and what have you are a lot of detail is lost in those shadows. So I'm going to open them pretty far. Yeah, about there. And then I'm going to increase the whites. Looking at my histogram, I have a little bit of room where I can increase the whites just a bit. And I'm going to slide my black slider to the left just to set a black point just before clipping. And then I'm going to boost the clarity. I'm going to leave it about there. And already it's an improvement. I'll just show you where we've come. That's there at the beginning, and this is where we are now. I'm also going to decrease the vibrance just a bit. And I'm doing that because when I go into the tone curve and I'm going to apply medium contrast, you'll see that it's going to bring back in some of that color. Why this is tied, I don't know, but it just so happens to do that in Lightroom. So a little bit of color is brought back in, a little bit of vibrance. I'm going to come back and play. Again, just a bit. Okay, and then I'm going to come down into, I'm going to play here for just a bit, you know, with the sky, because the sky really was just a beautiful blue. So I'm going to hit the luminance targeted adjustment tool, and I'm going to place the tool over the sky and point where it's blue, and I'm going to drag up on the slider. Okay, I'm not liking the luminance. Let me try the saturation and do the same thing. And it's picking the blue, but it's not really doing all that much. Well, let's see, I'm going to come back to where I was. And well, it gives some more definition. I'm going to leave it there and close out of the panel. Then I'm going to come down into the details panel, and I'm going to apply a little bit of sharpening. This again was 2 years ago, before I had started shooting in RAW. It is a JPEG, and I have a sharpen JPEG preset, and I will use that. And then let's see how the noise level is in here. Noise level is fine. So I'm not going to come into the luminance slider under noise reduction and deal with that at all. So I'm going to close out of the detail panel. And then last, I'm going to come in and apply a post-crop vignette. And I'll start with my lesser effect at the negative 10. And then I'm going to move up and just compare. And let's see, I'm going to come back here in the history just to see where we were. Here, there's the minus 10. And there's the minus 15. And I think I'm going to leave it there, minus 15. This was a rather simple photo to post-process. And let me come back into the beginning, to the before. But I think you'll see, and I think you'll agree, that the post-processing, though simple, is very powerful and really added punch, opened up the shadows, increased the clarity and the sharpness of the photo. And this is what the scene looked like the day I was there. Absolutely beautiful day. It was a wonderful event. And you get to experience a bit of that day here in this photo. So I hope you've enjoyed this week's video. Please feel free to ask any questions in the comments section. If you are watching this on YouTube, to see more post-processing videos and galleries of after-before photos, visit visualventuring.com and select After Before Friday Forum in the menu. Thanks for watching.